Hi guys, in this video I'm going to fix your slow internet problem in Windows 10 PC. Just follow the steps given in this video and your internet connection will boom up and speed will definitely improve a lot. So let's see how to do it. First of all, what you need to do is to click on start button and click on gear shaped icon to open settings. Once this settings control panel open up, what you need to do is to click on network and internet. Just click on it and now scroll down and you will find the thing network and sharing center. Just click on network and sharing center. Once network and sharing center opens up, you have to click on change adapter settings in the left menu. Now just do a right click on your connection, whether it's Wi-Fi or LAN. Just do a right click on from which you are getting the internet. Now click on properties. Now select internet protocol version TCP/ICP 4 and now click on properties. Now what you need to do is to just use the following DNS server address. Just change your DNS server address. If it is already there, just change it. If it is not there, just enter what I am saying, 8 8 8 8. Okay, and now in this 4 and 4. Okay, so this is 8 8 8 8 and 8 8 4 4. These are Google DNS settings. Okay, and these are one of the best DNS which is available on internet today. So just opt these Google DNS server settings and click on OK and finally exit, and your internet will become pretty fast. The next thing which can be done to improve your internet is to click on start button. Now click on this gear shaped icon and now in this click on privacy. Okay, in the privacy option, just scroll down the left menu and here you will find background apps. Just click on background apps. Okay, and now in the background apps you can go on and disabling them which you don't find important and without which you can go through in your PC. For example, this is Dell Customer Connect. I don't want Dell Customer Connect to send and receive background data from my PC and use my bandwidth and use my money. So I'll turn it off. Dell product registration, I do not need it currently now because I've already registered it. Okay, Dropbox promotion, okay, done all. So in this way, this is e-commerce website, and so in this way you can keep disabling many background apps which consume a lot of bandwidth from your PC. And in this way, your internet will become very fast. And if you are conservative enough, you can also go for this option. This will turn off all the background apps and your internet experience will be much smoother. Now, in this method, what we'll do, we'll disable Windows Update Service. So a lot of people will think that disabling Windows Update Service is not a good idea because Windows Update keeps us protected. But we are not. We are disabling Windows Update Services so that it will not bug us to automatically downloading updates in the background and stealing our bandwidth. We'll do it. We'll update our Windows manually by ourselves. When we want to, when we are not working. Okay. So how to do this? Let's see. First of all, what you need to do is to search services in the Windows taskbar search and click on services to open it. Now in this services window, what you need to do is to find Windows update. Okay, so here is Windows Update. Now right click on it and click on properties. Now what you need to do is to click on stop. Okay, so this is stop, and choose startup type is equals to disabled. Now click on apply and click on OK. So this will stop Windows Update Service. What you can do when you have stopped, you know, working, and you don't need, you know, to work. So in that case, just go to this Service Manager window again. Now click on this startup type is equals to automatic delayed start. Okay, apply, okay, and click on start. Okay, to start the service. So in this way, you're choosing when to, you know, allow this Windows Update Service to run in the background, and when to, you know, automatically stop it, so that it doesn't bug you, it doesn't consume bandwidth in background, so that you can work in a fast internet environment. Now many of the people don't use OneNote, but they are not able to uninstall it or remove it from your PC. So what you need to do is to completely get rid of OneNote. What you need to do is to just search for PowerShell. Okay, now right click and open is run. Once the PowerShell windows open up, what you need to do is to just run this code. Get apex package OneNote, remove apex package. Okay, just copy this command and, you know, just paste it here. I have given this command in the bottom of this video. Below this video, you are able to copy this code. Just hit enter and run it, and this OneNote will get removed. So in this way, OneNote will not able to consume bandwidth from your internet connection. And if you are not using OneNote, it is a good idea to get rid of this app. The next thing which you can do is to disable Windows auto tuning feature. What you need to do is to just press on Windows plus R and type cmd.exe. okay, click on OK to open cmd. okay, now what you need to do is to just copy this code, and paste it. I have given this code below this video. Netsh space interface space TCP space source space global. Okay, hit enter. Okay, if this receive Windows auto tuning level is normal. Okay, receive Windows auto tuning level. This is normal. Okay, so we can disable it. So by disabling it, will save bandwidth coming and going out of the system. What this auto tuning feature does, it, you know, enables programs to talk with each other using the bandwidth. So we don't necessarily want it, so we can disable it. So what we'll do, we'll just copy this code and paste it. Netsh space int space TCP space set space global space auto tuning level is equals to disabled, and hit enter, and your auto tuning feature will get disabled. So in this way, your bandwidth will be saved and your internet connection will become faster. So this was how to, you know, increase your internet speed to a large extent, guys. I hope that your problem must have got solved. Please do subscribe to our channel and like the video to support me so that I can keep making more helpful videos like this.